Hi, I'm Ram Gopal from presentationprocess.com. Now you can get a free sneak peek into Ram Gopal's PowerPoint Mastery membership program. The details are in the description box below this video. In this video, you will learn three tips you didn't know about improving your bar charts in PowerPoint. These three tips will take your bar charts to the next level and make it easy for your audience to understand your charts. This is how a typical bar chart looks on a PowerPoint slide. If you don't know how to insert a bar chart in PowerPoint, then I highly recommend you go to my other video, which shows you how to insert a bar chart in PowerPoint. I'm going to assume that you've already seen that video, and therefore I'm going to pick it from here and move forward. Now, this is a typical bar chart, and there are a few ways you can make this bar chart a lot better than the way it is right now. First, let us do a few quick visual enhancements. The first thing is you can see that these bars are fairly thin, so we need to improve the width of these bars. So I'm going to right click, go to Format Data Series, and then here you see the option called Gap Width. You can always reduce the gap width by going here. As you reduce the gap width, you can see that the individual bars are a lot thicker than they were before. And then I prefer to use a much darker color for my bars. So let me go to the Home tab in PowerPoint Ribbon, and for the Shape Fill, I'm going to go to the Shape Fill option and I'm going to choose maybe a black color or maybe dark gray color like this. And that makes the chart a lot more visible and a lot more elegant to look at on my PowerPoint slide. Now, what we have done is a basic improvement in the look and feel of the chart. Now, I'm going to show you the three tips that you can do to make this chart even better. Now, let us go to Edit Data and see how the chart data is shown. I'm going to right click on this and go to Edit Data. Now, you can see that this worksheet shows values in a certain order. You can see that the category names are listed from Andy, Becky, and so on, A to F. You know, this is the names that I've given conveniently, so you know that these are in a particular order. And whenever a bar chart is created by PowerPoint, the chart is usually arranged in reverse order. The category names are arranged in reverse order. Now, that makes it slightly difficult for the audience to read your data, because they are used to seeing the values in this order, and now you have the chart that shows the category names in reverse order. Is there a way to reverse this ordering of the category names? Yes. First, let me close this accompanying worksheet. Then I'm going to go to this vertical axis. As I click on this, you can see that my vertical axis is selected. Then I'm going to right click on that and go to Format Axis option. And here you have the option for Format Axis. And now here when you go down, you see that there is this option called Categories in Reverse Order. You check that one and instantly you see that the order in which the categories are named are exactly the same order in which you have entered the values. So this is a very useful thing, and it makes the life of audience much easier to read your values. So that is the first one. The next thing is, when you show your values like this, when you show the category names like this, it is one way to understand data. But typically, if I want to get a bit more of an insight from your data, then I would like to see this data sorted out in a particular order. I always prefer to sort the data in descending order so that the highest value is up here and then the value goes down from there. And let me show you how exactly to sort your data and present it in the bar chart so that it's easier for the audience to get a deeper insight into your data. So I'm going to right click on the chart. Then I'm going to go to Edit Data option, and here I'm going to just click on this arrow here, and that gives me two options. One is Edit Data, other one is Edit Data in Excel. We want to go to Edit Data in Excel. So I'm going to click on that option, and that opens up the Excel sheet attached with that particular data. Now I'm going to click and drag across all these values so that I can select all these values. Then let me go to Data tab in PowerPoint ribbon. Then go to this option called Sort. Now when I go to Sort, this particular dialog box opens up, and first what we're going to do is sort by sales, because that is the series name here. We are going to sort by sales, and it is going to be sorted on values, and the order is not going to be from smallest to largest, it is going to be from largest to smallest. And then I'm going to say okay, and as soon as I did that, you can see that the category names are now ordered automatically, and you have the values ordered in descending order. And I'm going to close this sheet, and now when I go back to the slide, you can see that the bar chart is automatically updated with the reverse, or the descending order in which the values are shown. So this is a much more easy and intuitive way to understand the values here. And the next thing I'm going to do is to make this chart even more easy for the audience to understand, and that is by highlighting a certain value. Let us say I want to show to the audience that Esther performed the best in the month of May. I'm going to say Esther performed the best in May. I prefer to have my slide title as clear and as explicit as possible so that the audience doesn't have to think about what is the conclusion that you want to make out of this chart. So you write your conclusion in clear full sentence in your slide title, so that your audience first looks at the conclusion here, and then they come to your chart to see for the evidence, and then they instantly get the point of your chart. Now, this title is very clear, and it's easy for the audience to see the value here. Now, to make it even easier for the audience to pick up the information, I'm going to highlight the value of Esther in a different color. When I click on the chart first, you can see that all the bars are selected. When I click on one particular data point, once again, you can see that that particular data is selected. Then I can go to Shape Fill and choose a different color so that it is easy for the audience to see that Esther performed best in May, and here the value is very clearly obvious. And now this chart is way better than the chart that we started out with. So to do a quick recap of what we learned in this video, first we did an aesthetic enhancement of the chart by increasing the width here. Then I showed you how exactly to reverse the category order so it's easier for the audience to read the value. Then I showed you how you can sort the data in the descending order so that your data is far more insightful for your audience. And then finally, I showed you how to make your chart a lot clearer for your audience by writing your conclusion explicitly in the title, that is slide title, and then highlighting that particular data point on the chart. So those are the three quick tips that you didn't know about improving your bar charts in PowerPoint. Hey, are you looking for an easy to follow, comprehensive and creative PowerPoint training online? Do you want to learn how to create beautiful picture slides like this, chart slides like this, infographics like this, 3D graphics like this, or in general, beautiful slides like this, this, or this? Then please join our Ram Gopal's PowerPoint Mastery membership program. It is arguably the most comprehensive and creative PowerPoint training online. You get instant access to more than 650 step-by-step video tutorials, more than 225 text-based lessons, and more than 400 downloadable files the moment you join Ram Gopal's PowerPoint Mastery membership program. You can sign up for a free sneak peek into the program right away. Please click here to watch a few of the premium videos from the program for free right now. I'll see you inside the program.